The main thing that I want to say about the difference in driving on the open roadway, which is like out in the country, is that there is not enough light out there. Think about it. Last time you were on a country road, you're driving around, there's no light. As a result, when you're going around curves, you're hard to see. It's hard to see anything. You can't see that there's no shoulder on the side of the road. You can't see signs, the guide signs. They tell you how many miles you've gone and that sort of thing until the very last minute. Freeways and city streets, by and large, are much well lit, and as opposed to country roads, which are not that well lit. Another thing that people pointed out to was livestock. Livestock crossing the road. Deer jumping out in front of you, that sort of thing. Now, you have to watch out for that sort of thing. And again, there's hardly any light out there, and you really have to keep an eye open. Remember, you are allowed to keep your bright headlights on a country road or on any road where there's no traffic coming at you within 500 feet, and you're not following another car within 300 feet. And that's about the length of a football field. So on a dark road, don't be afraid to put your bright lights on as long as there are no cars that are following you or coming at you within 500 feet. There are a lot of roadside stands out in the country. I never thought of that before people pointed out to me. There are roadside stands on the side of a country road selling peaches and apples and stuff. So that is your merging lane, people coming out of that. Or the little mom and pop gas station on the side of the road, people pulling out or going into that. You have to watch out for those sort of things also. You have a lot of farm equipment on open roads, tractors, slow-moving trucks, that sort of thing. There is no light on curves, and you're going around. There are much narrower roads, more narrow roads. A lot of times you have tremendous potholes on country roads that you cannot see. Okay, there is more of a chance of skidding or hydroplaning out on country roads because there's more oil, dirt accumulated, that sort of thing. And while I'm thinking about that, let me ask you, what is the worst time of day to drive as far as rainfall goes? Right when it starts. That's true. The first half hour rain, it is tremendously slippery on a road. And I'll tell you why. When cars ride over a road, they drop fragments of dust, mostly oil, gas, any kind of residue from their truck or the car, and it lands on the pavement. Then, when the rain comes, a light mist especially is very bad because it just wets that stuff on the road and it makes it very, very slippery. So you better be careful the first half hour to an hour of rainfall. Very slippery. Try never to drive at all during the first half hour of rain. I also want to talk to you about hills. A lot of times in country roads, let's say you're going up to ski somewhere, you have these little two-lane narrow roads and they're uphill or downhill. This is a question that hardly anybody ever gets. You're driving on a two-lane road, you're going uphill, guys coming at you going downhill, who has the right of way? I'll give you 3 seconds to come up with the answer. The car going uphill has the right of way. There are a lot of reasons for that. The most important one is this. When you're going uphill, you have your momentum because you're going up. And if you have to stop, it is extremely hard to get that momentum going up again. People going downhill, they just have to put on their brakes. And then they let go of the brakes up again, and they're going down again. Your car, think about this, if you had to stop, think about how hard it is to maneuver your car if you had to back down a hill. Here's another question for you about country roads. If you're on a little two-lane road out in the country and some guy is crossing your lane and about to hit you, where do you go? On a freeway, you have 4 lanes. A lot of city streets, you have 4 lanes. You could escape. Country roads, you have to go off the side of the road. That's it. And there are ditches on the side of the road sometimes in the country. You might end up in a ditch. My Uncle Boudreaux, I called him last week and I had to admit he's not the brightest guy in the whole world. He keeps a coat hanger in his car in case he locks himself out. And he told me that he took that aptitude test to go back to school. They told him not only is he not college material, he's not even high school material. And that's kind of sad because he's been the principal of my high school for 5 years now.